The USDA MyPlate guidelines suggest that individuals devote at least a quarter of their plates to fruits and devote at least a quarter of their plates to foods rich in protein, including nuts. Fruits have a high nutrient content and are important sources of vitamins A, B, and B6, as well as potassium, magnesium, copper, and iron. Fruit contains fiber and are high in antioxidants. The branch of horticulture dealing with producing, storing, processing, and marketing fruits and nuts is called pomology. Fruits and nuts can be produced commercially or by the homeowner. Commercial fruit and nut production can be broken down into two distinct areas, fresh marketing and processing. The United States is one of the world leaders in the production of fruits and nuts. In 2011, the value of the U.S. non-citrus fruit crops totaled $13.9 billion. The citrus crop was $3.0 billion, and the tree nut crop was valued at $6.1 billion. Most fruits are grown for both the fresh market and processing, with more than half being produced for the fresh market. The largest fruit-producing states are California, 50%, Florida, 20%, and Washington, 10%. California is the largest producer of grapes, strawberries, peaches, nectarines, and kiwi fruit, whereas Florida's fruit crop is primarily citrus and Washington's fruit crops are apples, grapes, and pears. The top four tree nut crops produced in the United States are almonds, pecans, pistachios, and walnuts. The top four producers of tree nuts are California, 90%, Georgia, New Mexico, and Texas. I'm Dr. DeBusk, and in this video, I'll discuss the types of fruits as well as planting, growing, and storing a fruit. Fruits can be obtained from a variety of plants, including the trees grown in orchards to small herbaceous plants. Small fruits are defined as a collective term for plants that produce edible fruits that are relatively small in size. Small fruits are a general term that includes many domesticated species that are cultivated for their berry-like fruits. Compared to fruit trees, small fruit plants are smaller and, in terms of growth habit, may be herbs, vines, bushes, or shrubs. Small fruits are perennials and are often woody. They are dicot angiosperms and typically cultivated in temperate regions. They are propagated vegetatively rather than by seed. Unlike fruit trees, most small fruits can be harvested within 1 or 2 years of planting and are typically easier to cultivate than fruit trees. Examples of small fruits are grapes, strawberries, and blackberries. Nut trees are trees that bear indehiscent, single-seeded fruits with a hard pericarp or shell. Examples of nuts grown commercially are chestnut, almonds, pecans, and peanuts. Fruits have many different forms and shapes. The three major types of fruits are simple fruits, aggregate fruits, and multiple fruits. Simple fruits are comprised of a single ovary with or without some other flower parts, which have developed as part of the fruit. Simple fruits can be broken down into two groups: fruits with a fleshy pericarp, for example berries, and fruits with a dry pericarp, for example walnuts. Another type of fruit is an aggregate fruit, which is comprised of a single receptacle, base of the flower, with masses of similar fruitlets, for example blackberries and strawberries. The last type of fruit is a multiple fruit, which is comprised of ovaries of many separate but closely clustered flowers, for example pineapple. To select the proper site, these environmental factors must be considered: light, rainfall, wind, soil, topography, water, air pollution, and plant pests. There are economic factors to consider as well: land costs and availability, labor, transportation, utilities and services, and competition. Finally, storage and other facilities are important to a successful fruit-producing location, including cold storage facilities, shipping areas, offices, pesticide storage and mixing areas, and storage buildings. Establishing plants that produce fruit is a long-term commitment, so selecting the proper cultivar is crucial. The fruit crop must be readily adapted to the climate at the location selected, because to grow at peak efficiency, all plants must be grown within their optimum temperature range. Fruit crops can be grown at any climate, but only certain species of fruit will grow and produce well. It is very important to consider winter hardiness, or how low a temperature the flower buds and plant can withstand without damage. In North America, winter freezes present a significant hazard in fruit production. Fruit crops demand a consistent supply of water, and any stress leads to a reduction in quality and yields. The selected cultivar should be adaptable to the location selected. Sunlight is needed for photosynthesis and color formation in fruits, so high light intensity is important for high yields and quality. Day length determines when some fruit crops flower. For example, June-bearing strawberries form flower buds in response to long days. A cultivar should be selected that will produce good yields and have the desired horticultural characteristics such as color, size, flavor, shape, and appearance. The cultivar should also ripen in the correct market window. The cultivar selected should have good resistance to pests and diseases at the location in which it will be grown. In many cases, the cultivar must be grafted onto the proper rootstock to overcome certain problems. A rootstock is a root system and base of a tree on which the fruiting top or scion is budded or grafted. Rootstocks are used to make plants tolerate poorly drained soil conditions, to protect them from nematodes and soil diseases, and to control size, for example, apples and pear trees. Next, the land must be prepared properly prior to installing the fruit crop. Soil tests are run to determine the amount of nutrients to add and whether pH adjustments are necessary. The soil should have good water holding capacity, and if not, it should be amended to correct any problems. An adequate supply of water is very important in fruit production, so installing irrigation and drainage systems may be necessary at certain locations, depending on the tensiometer readings used to measure soil moisture. Large rocks and other objects should be removed and the soil plowed to remove any hard pans, to level the land, to increase soil aeration and moisture infiltration, to control weeds, and to incorporate crop residue and fertilizer or lime as necessary. Roads within the orchard should be carefully planned and designed to maximize efficiency prior to installing fruit crops. The rows should be laid out according to the type of fruit crop being grown. Fruit trees can be laid out in a checkerboard or diamond pattern to maximize light penetration. The best orientation is north-south, which allows both sides of the plant to receive sun. The east side receives sun during the morning hours, whereas the west side receives sun during the afternoon. Fruit crops should be installed by standard methods such as soil preparation, fertilization, and others. After the crop has been installed, proper care and maintenance helps ensure high quality and yield. Commercial fruit crops should be fertilized in a scientific manner, starting with an extensive soil sampling and testing. Soil sampling should be followed with a leaf analysis to determine the nutrient content of the leaves and to decide how many nutrients to apply to promote good growth but not overstimulate the plant. Plants should be watered based on demand. However, it is important to know that crop demands will vary with the species, time of year, and plant size. Good pest control is also necessary for high yields, so an IPM approach should be used to control pests. Pruning is one of the most expensive and labor-intensive aspects of fruit production. Pruning increases fruit quality, such as color, by allowing more sunlight and air movement to the plant. Reduces disease problems and allows pesticide applications to better penetrate the tree, and increases fruit and overall plant size. Fruit thinning can be done either by hand, which is a very labor-intensive practice, or by using chemical thinning agents, which is a commonly used practice in the United States. In fruit trees, thinning eliminates problems with biennial bearing, which is when trees fruit on alternate years, prevents physical damage to the tree, and enhances fruit size, shape, color, and overall quality. Unanticipated frosts damage fruit crops annually, whereas fruit crops are more tolerant to higher temperatures. In some cases, nothing can be done to prevent damage. However, in many cases, severe damage can be prevented by being knowledgeable about the type of freeze and how to prevent damage. Many fruiting plants have flowers that emerge early in the spring. After flowers have emerged, damage typically occurs at temperatures at or below 28 degrees Fahrenheit. For this reason, site selection in relation to spring freezes is very important in fruit production. The two types of freezes that commonly occur are advective and radiation. Advective freezes are accompanied by wind and can be overcome by the proper site selection or through the use of windbreaks. Radiation freezes occur on still, clear nights. Protection against this type of freeze is achieved by using overhead sprinklers, covering the crop, or using heaters. Heat tolerance is the capability of a plant to tolerate high temperatures and still produce well. High temperatures can also cause severe damage to fruit crops. However, this is not typically a problem in most fruit growing areas. Recognizing when the crop is mature is important to harvest at peak color, flavor, and overall quality. Fruits are harvested at different stages of maturity for different uses and markets. During the winter months, fruit trees experience winter dormancy, so knowing when a fruit tree's buds will break is important for adequately caring for and maintaining the orchard. The two types of dormancy are endodormancy and ectodormancy. Endodormancy, rest, is the dormancy of seeds and buds imposed by internal blocks which are removed by winter chilling and is regulated by endogenous levels of plant hormones. Ectodormancy, quiescence, is a state in which the plant is not growing and will not grow until external conditions are satisfied, usually with warmer temperatures. Both endodormancy and ectodormancy work together to prevent plants from breaking bud dormancy during the wrong time of the year. This is not a perfect system, however, because under unusual weather conditions, fruit trees can be fooled. For example, the citrus crop in Florida has been lost on a number of occasions, which drives up prices of fruits. By first determining the winter chilling requirement and the heat units requirement, the grower will know when the buds will break and be prepared for problems with freezing temperatures and problems when the crop reaches maturity. The winter chilling requirement is calculated in most areas of the United States by how many hours at and below 45 degrees Fahrenheit are required during the winter for the plant to break its winter resting period and develop normally when temperatures rise in the spring. There is a range of chilling requirements for each species that differs between cultivars within the species. For example, the chilling hours for the Florida peach cultivar Gulf Snow is 400 chill units to break dormancy, which would occur in North Florida. After a tree has received its winter chilling requirement, it requires a specific heat unit requirement for bud break to occur. The heat unit requirement is the number of hours of warmth needed for a certain growth phase to occur. Heat units are calculated by taking the average temperature for the day minus 50 degrees Fahrenheit, which is the minimum temperature for growth of fruit trees. For example, if the average temperature for the day is 68 degrees Fahrenheit, the grower subtracts 50 from this number to get 18 heat units. Whereas if the average temperature for the day is 40 degrees Fahrenheit, the grower subtracts 50 to get 0 heat units for the day. Plant growth regulators, PGRs, are used to chemically thin flowers and fruits, prevent fruit drop, induce fruit abscission, control fruit ripening, and others. After fruits are mature, they must be harvested properly. Certain types of fruits used for processing are often picked mechanically. These fruits include raspberries, blackberries, cherries, and others. Most large fruits are picked by hand. After the fruit is harvested, it is still living, so the first step is to remove the field heat rapidly and place the fruit in an appropriate storage conditions. Prior to harvesting, be prepared to market the fruits properly and thus give the products a chance to sell. In conclusion, you now understand the importance of pomology. The three major types of fruits are simple, aggregate, and multiple. The important aspects of fruit crop establishment are site selection and necessary facilities, cultivar selection, rootstocks, land preparation, and proper planting. Fruit crops also require proper care and maintenance. Growers must understand the intricacies of crop maturation, using plant growth regulators, harvesting, storing, and marketing to create a successful production.